That's what I read. False footwear. I'm wearing the shoes you stole from me. It feels as though I'm wearing lies on my feet. And they are oddly comfortable. Thank you.
Talking, is that your book?
No, that's her book. Alexandra Ostolaza.
Okay.
She comes here.
Okay.
There's a book there. Okay. Book rack. That's a lot of poets that are alive.
Good.
I usually honor the poets that are alive. Because we poets, we only get mentioned when we die.
Well, I'm a ghost.
Yeah.
I'm a ghost, though.
This is my book, though. The only one left. I gotta print it again.
See that?
This will be printed soon. This is Murmuro. It's a black pages. It's the sexiest book you've ever seen. Really amazing. And
black pages with black text.
Black pages. And the thing is that this book came out in depression. And when I came out of depression, that's what made me a poet. And that's when I realized that poetry was a healing device of some sort. And what you have here is caca. I mean, this is... Yo sabía. I did it for you. This is Eduardo Cole. He told me, watch your language. And I like that, you know. I'm going to read English because there's a lot of English crowds. So this is my other book. It's called Insane. Insane. So I'm going to read the prologue. I'll do a poem. Is it on or in? I think it should be on. You're on saying. Meaning you were sane at some point and now you're not. To be insane means something else. Just that independent is to depend on your inner faculties. When the philosopher meets the poet, insanity happens. Two kinds in search of inner sanity. One is the shooter of emotions, the poet. And the other is the sniper, seeker, and destroyer of illusions, the philosopher. Both working as one in search of insanity, sane inside, insane. In a world that resembles Lego, you will be called insane if you're introverted. I have been called crazy. But every time they do, I reply, hey, I'm not crazy. I'm insane. Get it right. But it is they who always leave with the impression that they were right. Somehow we always agree to disagree. In between these poems, there is a dialogue between the two extremities of humanity. One is the clown, the other one is an Indian. And it's very entertaining. I'm looking for a poem. This is called Outlandish. It's about depression. It's kind of like explanation. It's kind of about outlandish. Sometimes the senses are too much. It cannot go formal and enchanted to a rather dance into a form of condition which thousand words cannot express or inject a subliminal universe on a crystal ball in spite of the way it comes. And these words are the lift of a curtain that once is dropped, seeks no more to be understood, but to be indeed something. So peculiar, so tacit, so old, it has gone back to the entire cycle of time, and is now coming from behind, honking. But not to make you aware that it's coming, but to let you know this about to blindside your left flank with a single swoop. Spinning you around, make you realize it. That is emotional. So emotional, the ego cannot be. Let me just try. Let me make an attempt. Let me just try, because I can't even describe the magnitude of this thing. I want to allow you to feel something. Imagine it's the night, and you're watching TV, and the window's open, and a man walks through the window and looks from outside in. And you look up, and you lock eyes with this man, and you don't know. You notice the expanding follicles. Multiply that 1,000 times. What kind of strength, what kind of inner strength is necessary to survive if not you? It's like it takes you back into a lookout in, into a time in which you was free. This you do not see, but feel the emotion that took it there and let it hear. The initial shock is the sum of all fears. Now waiting to be conquered.